Welcome back. This is Yamajac. I should probably wait a little bit longer before I say welcome back so that the thing's actually recording and you don't just get back. It's Yamajac, you know, kind of thing. But anyway, we are here. Krampus's Lair, Hell on Earth, Gunslinger. And we are going to get a win. I love Gunslinger because it's so fast. There are two reasons I love playing Commando, okay? The first reason is simple. Commando is fun. Right? Very simple reason why I like playing Commando. It is fun. Okay? Commando's fun. I like playing it. Simple, right? The other reason why I like playing Commando is because it makes Gunslinger so much more fun when I eventually go back to it. Because I'm so fast. I'm a little speedy girl, you know? Feels good. And I like it. It's like, you know, yin and yang kind of stuff, right? You can't have the good without the bad. You can't have the fast without the slow. If you don't have a recent... I'm gonna die. No, I'm not. Clutch AF timing on that. Come on. I don't want to be backed into this corner. I don't really like this corner. Okay, see ya. This is dual 9mm, which are okay as a weapon, I suppose, for this kit. You just die. Get out of here. Alright, let's go get a real weapon, like a Glock. Like a Glock. I gotta get that, like, I think I know this word. I learned so many words. I love learning new things. I'll pick that up when I get my Glock. Actually, I have enough money. We can pick it up for the grenades. I don't want to backtrack. Glad you made it back. I learned so many new words talking to people. That's one of my favorite things about talking to people, honestly. Is just learning new things. Because people know so many things, right? Everybody knows things about things, right? Like people from the UK, they know what the National Express is, probably, right? I don't know what the National Express is. People from, you know, Australia, they'll know what kangaroo smells like or something, you know, like you don't get that because you live in a different area and you have different cultures and whatnot. And then there's people who go into specific education for different things and they'll learn about this is too many EDARs, okay? Too many EDARs. They'll learn about specific things, you know, math or science or language or whatever it may be, and they'll learn about it, and you won't because you didn't go to that school to learn about that thing. You'll know about something else, right? And I love learning about stuff when I'm talking to people. It's so much fun. So much fun. Kind of puts me in a situation where it's like, well, I don't really know too much about any one thing, you know? Because what I love to do is talk to people and learn about what they love to do, right? But that's never enough to learn it on the same level as them, right? Like, if I wanted to learn, if I'm talking to, you know, a friend of mine who is super into, like, biology, right? Say I've got a friend who's super into biology and I'm talking to them. Right, they've gone to school for 4 years and studied and, you know, learned about this stuff. They've been using it practically for years. You know, they know what they're talking about intimately, right? And I'm like, so what really is the, you know, the mitochondria? And they explain it to me and I'm like, oh, okay, I get it. You know, but I don't really have an intimate understanding of the biological makeup of stuff or what the different cells are used for and all this kind of stuff, right? Like, I don't have that intimate knowledge that you only get after spending years with it, right? So, as somebody who spends a lot of time learning tidbits from other people, I never actually really master anything too well, right? I would say I'm pretty up there in the whole programming thing, and I would say I'm pretty up there in the certain types of maths type of stuff, but like largely, Yoink. I don't know a whole lot about any one subject. I'm not an expert on anything. I'm a jack of all, master of none, so to speak, right? I mean, that's okay. That's okay, because I get to know a lot of tidbits, a little bit of information that most people might find utterly uninteresting, but to me is some of the most interesting stuff there can be. And I'm not going to get into discussing it all right now, because you're putting me on the spot, you know? You're putting me on the spot here, being like, oh, well, what kind of stuff do you know? I don't know. Like, diacritics? I learned what those are yesterday. Like, I didn't know those before. I never used diacritics. And for those that don't know, it's like the little fancy symbols above letters sometimes, like above an O or an E or something. Like in Naive, there'd be a little diacritic above the I. Yeah, so that's a diacritic. And there's specific names for the different ones, like, I don't know. I can't think of the names. I know them. But, you know, you put me on the spot like this, and I can't tell you. Like, I know what those are. I learned what those are yesterday, you know? That's cool. I learned, I used agglutinative in an episode not too recently, but sort of recently-ish. We're just gonna kill you with shots to the gut. You know, it's, learning things is fun, but then I can't really use them in sentences. This is the moral of the story. I learn what they are, I learn about them, their existence, their presence in this world, but I can't internalize them so much. I suppose that if I were to say that I know any one thing, it would be how to, handle panic attacks. But I couldn't explain it to you. But I can do it. Give me a panic attack and I'm not gonna, you know, off myself. At least. Where are all of the big Zeds? I haven't seen a big Zed yet. I mean, you're not a big Zed. You're a small Zed. I mean, you're a medium Zed, but... medium Zeds and small Zeds are the same thing. To Gunslinger? There's no difference between them. You're a small Zed. Actually, you're a medium Zed. I forgive them. I forgive the medium Zeds. The Gorfiends are medium Zeds to Gunslingers, but you? You're a small Zed. I missed you a bunch of times, but I mean, I can miss a small Zed too. In fact, the smaller Zed's probably harder to miss. Look at all those misses. Ouch. What? Oh, the crawlers, they just come up on you so fast, you know? One moment they're not there, and then the next moment you're dead. It's rough. I don't like it. I don't like it. I should have kept moving. I shouldn't have stopped. It's my fault. It's my fault. I understand. We're going to do some verticality. Because I want to do some verticality. And why not, right? Why not? Let's just do it. I like Krampus' lair a lot, though. I should have kept moving. If I kept moving, we would have won. I stopped in a bad place to stop, too. Like, that's not even a good spot to stop to camp. That's the worst spot. I know if I were to try and think of any one thing that I know intimately. One thing that I've invested a lot of time into. And that I know better than, like, the average person who cares about it at all. Right? Like, you know, you've got people who care about biology. Right? They probably know more than me about biology. Right? Even if they haven't gone to you know, secondary... Or higher education of any kind. Post-secondary, I suppose, is the correct terminology for it. Not secondary, but... anybody who's gone to college or university about it would definitely know more of me. But somebody who's just been passionate about it, even in, you know, high school, probably also knows more than me about biology. Just because I probably don't even have, you know, like a biology 12th grade education. You know, level of that. I mean, I dropped out of high school in the first place in like grade 10, so I don't even have a grade 12 education at all, but don't stay in school, kids. Not a good idea to leave. I mean, if I get successful on YouTube, then maybe it was, but It definitely wasn't because I dropped out. I did not drop out for this. Anyway. Yeah, to say that one thing that I know better than the average person that has a passing interest in it, probably would be either Python or like Minecraft. Like I'm probably a much better Minecraft player than anybody else. Not anybody else, but like there are probably very, very few people who understand Minecraft more intimately than me. And I know that, you know, people are gonna be like, oh, well, what about SciCraft or Prototech or, you know, whatever. And I'm like, yeah, those would be the very few people, you know? Like those would be it, right? Like, you're not, you go on the Hermitcraft server or Mindcrack or whatever. You go on any random server, like, I probably understand Minecraft more intimately than your average person who's interested in Minecraft. Which, you know, that's not really something to be proud of necessarily. Like, if I made a living on it, like if I made Minecraft YouTube videos and that was my living, then I guess I could be proud of it. But at the moment, it's just like, yeah, it's a hobby that I happen to know quite a bit about. And that's, to a certain extent, kind of disappointing because it means that there isn't really anything in my life where I'm like, yeah, I'm super passionate about this and I want to make it my career. You know? There aren't many things in my life, there isn't anything in my life that I am super passionate about that could even be considered to be a career option, you know? Like, there's nothing practical, I guess, is what I'm saying. You know, everything that I'm interested in lacks practical use. Which is, kind of sad. But then I'm also like, yeah, but I'm also, you know, pretty happy with my life as it is. So, I mean, it's all good. It's all good. I don't know. There just isn't anything that I'm, like, super interested in. I mean, it's kind of true for most people with autism in the first place, though, so. Well, that's not quite true. There are a lot of things that I'm super interested in. Like, right now I'm super duper interested in RuneScape, but give me, like, a month or two at most, and I'm going to lose that interest, right? There's nothing long-term that has managed to hold my interest as much as YouTube, but I've never been successful on it. I've never properly invested the time to learn how it all works until now, when it's kind of working out pretty successfully. And, yeah. I don't know. Today it feels good for it to be working out successfully. I don't know why it goes that way. And I always do it, too. I always follow it. I trust in the system too much. Maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I shouldn't. Oh, yeah. There's supposed to be collectibles here. Like, if I toss a nade there, it's going to hit a collectible, right? That's going to hit me. If I toss a nade there, it's going to hit a collectible. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I hit a collectible, right? Didn't I? Maybe it would have told me. I don't know. There's a collectible somewhere around here anyway. Just toss out a bunch of nades. Not seeing the collectible. Do not know where the collectible is. But there is collectibles. I know that there are. I love this Glock, though. Such a fantastic weapon. I hate these stupid EDARs, though. Want to know something I hate? It's the EDARs. These stupid rockets. You know, people hate the trappers. I hate the trappers too. Don't get me wrong. I hate all the EDARs. You're walking around, you're kiting something, you get stuck by a trapper. That one time, it happens once, and you're like, yeah, no, I hate the trappers. Hey, I hate the trappers. They can leave. But the stupid rocketers, like before you had husks who could shoot rockets at you, right? And they already sucked. But now you've got Edars who just fire these like rapid fire rockets at you. And it's like, this is too many rockets. This is too many rockets. You get like three Edars firing rockets at you at once, and I mean, how are you supposed to avoid all of that damage? You can avoid some of them. You know, don't get me wrong. Some of them can be avoided. But like, that is just far, far too many rockets to be comfortably avoided in any situation, in my opinion, anyway. It's too many rockets. Too many rockets. Then the Edar trappers come in and they trap you, and then all the rocketeers are rocketing you, and it's just a whole disaster, really. It doesn't get much worse than that. Alright, there we go, we got that. We're going to take the HRG Winterbite because I feel like it, okay? Is it a good weapon? No, it's horrible. I'm pretty sure the single HRG Winterbite is actually completely useless because I'm pretty sure I literally cannot freeze the boss with it. Maybe with the duels I could. Possibly with the duels I could. Likely not. But since it is the Abomination, he's kind of susceptible to being frozen, so like, maybe. But definitely not with the... it's not even up for debate with the single Winterbite. Like, I cannot freeze him with this. I just don't think I can get out that much cold damage in that little time, you know? Don't think it's possible to be done. Where are you going, buddy? That's all of our deagle ammo. That's okay. They don't take that much extra damage on headshots, really. They don't. You just want to keep it up because of that 50% damage from rack 'em up. And then you do get, like, I don't know, 20% or 30% damage bonus on headshots with this guy as well. Which is nothing, but it's not much. As long as you're keeping the rack 'em up, you're, like, probably doing fine. Minus the armor as well, so I guess it's, like, super important to get headshots. But with the Glock, you're not really going to be hitting all headshots, so you don't have to worry too much about the shots that are missing the head. Just make sure you hit them, at least, right? It's more important to hit them at all than to miss the head, in my opinion. Anyway, that'll do it for today. Thank you for watching. Remember to like the video if you like it, subscribe to see more in the future, comment if you have anything to say, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.